Hello students, in today's class, let us learn about the Gibbs paradox. So in this paradox, we actually come across a situation where the Boltzmann relation and the entropy equation that we get from that relation actually kind of contradicts the real observations that we make. So let us study the problem here. So consider a box like this that is separated into two equal halves. Suppose the volume of the first compartment is V1 and that of the second compartment is V2. And inside the first compartment, we have one type of gas. N1 number of them are there. And in the second compartment, we have another kind of gas. N2 number of molecules are there inside this box. Suppose the entropy of the first box is given by S1 and the entropy of the second compartment is given by S2, and the total entropy of the system will be S1 plus S2. Now suppose we remove this partition and allow the gases to mix. So we will have a mixture. Its total volume will be V1 plus V2. The total number of molecules will be N1 plus N2 and the molecules are of different kind. Now let us calculate the total entropy of the system. Suppose the entropy is given by say S. So here we see a change in entropy. Initially it is S1 plus S2. After we allow the gases to mix, the entropy changes to a new value S. So here we have a change in entropy delta S associated with this mixing process. Since this reaction that we are allowing to happen is irreversible, the entropy change should be greater than zero. This particular action is irreversible because we know if we allow different type of gases to mix, we cannot separate them back without doing some work. It is impossible to naturally separate this different types of molecules back into separate compartments. Once it is mixed, it is over. It is irreversible. So we call this action irreversible action. And this kind of mixing of different types of molecules should be associated with a net change in entropy, and delta S should be greater than zero for an irreversible process. That is known. And let us consider another case. Here we have the same boxes here. Compartment 1 with volume V1, compartment 2 with volume V2. The only difference is that we have same kind of molecules in both the compartments. We have N1 molecules here and N2 molecules here. The only thing is that they are same molecules in this situation. Now again, we remove this partition and allow the gases to mix. And we have total volume V1 plus V2, total number of particles N1 plus N2. And those are the new situation that comes as a result of this action. Now here again, let us calculate the entropy. First, S1 is the entropy of this compartment. S2 is the entropy associated with the second compartment, so that S1 plus S2 is the entropy. Similarly, we calculate the entropy of the new system, which is S. And this action is reversible, right? Because we can say intuitively that when we mix these particles, since they are same, if we put back the partition here, we are just reverting back to the initial system. It's quite easy to separate them into two compartments with N1 and N2 particles. So this is a reversible action. And for such action, the net entropy change delta S should be equal to zero, since this is reversible. So this is the system that we have. This is the prediction that we have. These are the assumptions that we hold in our mind before starting. Now let us use the usual equations that we have in order to analyze these systems. So since these are Maxwell-Boltzmann particles, we know the equation for entropy S is K log W, right? This is the universal equation, the Boltzmann relation, S equal to K log W. And for Maxwell-Boltzmann particles, the W value is calculated to be n factorial into pi equal to 1 to n gi raised to ni whole divided by ni factorial. So this is the equation for W in the case of Maxwell-Boltzmann particles. Capital N is the total number of particles. Gi are different quantum levels, different number of cells, degeneracy. Ni is the number of particles occupying each the ith level, and so on. Now we can use this W value back into this equation of entropy. We can substitute for W and solve this to find final equation for entropy. So let us take that final equation. We can prove that if we substitute this value of W for Maxwell-Boltzmann particle and calculate the entropy value, we will obtain S to be equal to pi by 2 nk plus nk log n by v into 2 pi nkt by x square whole raised to 3 by 2 plus k log n factorial. So this is the equation for entropy that we will get if we substitute for W into the equation for entropy. This W corresponds to the Maxwell-Boltzmann classical particles. So we have the equation for entropy. Now we can put this equation into different situations here. We can calculate the value of S1, we can calculate the value of S2, and we can calculate the value of S separately using this equation 1. Now then, if we calculate the value of delta S from our equation, if we calculate delta S from 1, in the case of the first experiment, we can find this delta S to be greater than 0. So the theoretical prediction confirms with the experimental observations in the case 1. But in case 2, if we again do the same equations, use the same equation and calculate the delta S, case 2 corresponds to identical particles in both the boxes. So if we calculate delta S, again it is found to be greater than 0 from equation 1. But that should not be the case. We know delta S should be equal to 0 in this case. But if we use this equation predicted by the Maxwell-Boltzmann statistics and the Boltzmann's relation, what we get is delta S is greater than 0, where it should have been delta S equal to 0. So in this particular situation, the classical prediction does not go hand in hand with the actual result. This is the paradox that we come across, or this is the paradox that is put forward in this Gibbs paradox case. The actual result or the theoretical prediction is in contradiction with the actual observation or the conclusion drawn. And how can we remove this paradox? How can we correct this? We should get delta S equal to 0. And in order to correct that, this equation 1 has to be modified. This equation 1 should be corrected by removing the last term. If we remove this term, then we can actually get delta S to be greater than 0 in the case 1 and delta S equal to 0 in the case 2 situation. So this term should be removed from this equation of entropy. So I can rewrite the equation. The actual equation should be like S equal to 5 by 2 nk plus nk log n by v into 2 pi mkt divided by h square whole raised to 3 by 2. This should be the actual equation. And this equation is in fact verified for high temperatures experimentally for different gases. And this equation is called Sapkowski-Tetrode equation. The corrected one is called Sapkowski-Tetrode equation. So this correction factor is actually equivalent to removing this n factorial from W. Removing k log n factorial from the S is equivalent to cutting out the n factorial term from the equation of W. Both are one and same. So let me rewrite the Sapkowski-Tetrode equation. Instead of this 5 by 2 nk, I can write it is nk into log e raised to 5 by 2. Log e raised to 5 by 2 is just 5 by 2. Log and e are opposite functions plus nk log n pi v 2 pi m kt divided by x square all raised to 3 by 2. So I can take nk as common. I can write it as log n pi v 2 pi m kt divided by x square all raised to 3 by 2 into e raised to 5 by 2. And this is the actual equation for entropy. The earlier equation should be modified in order to correct the Gibbs paradox. So this is the essence of Gibbs paradox. It accounts or it tells the difference in the observation and the theoretical prediction when we come to calculation of entropy of mixing of identical gas. When we mix identical gas, delta S should have been zero, whereas the Maxwell-Boltzmann equations actually predicted delta S to be greater than zero. That was the paradox involved in the situation. I hope this portion is clear for you. Thank you.